In this video, I'll show you how to migrate your MS Access data and make it accessible via a web application. To start things off, let's take a quick look at the data we'll be working with. Here we have a simple Access database. I have a list of customers and a list of orders. You'll see that I have a form here where I can add orders to my database and a form to add new customers. And I have a little Visual Basic script here that sends me an email when a new order has been added. Okay, so that's my starting point. Now I want to convert all of this into a web application. And the first step in migrating your Access data to the web is getting it out of Access, because MS Access is a file server type of database. Instead, you need to move the data out of Access into a client server database such as MySQL or MSSQL. I won't go into all of the reasons why, as that would take too much time, but just know that if you want to migrate your Access data to the web, you must first move it into a client server database. Once you do that, you can build web applications over that data, which I'm going to show you in this video. Now, there are many ways to get your data out of Access, as you can see here. If you have a database set up, you can export directly to it using the ODBC connector, or I can export to XML, or a number of other methods. For sake of simplicity in this video, I'll export the data using Excel. I could use any of these other methods, but Excel is the most straightforward. I'll export each of these tables into different Excel sheets. Now that I have my data out of Access, I can build web apps over it. I'm planning to build a web application that mimics the capabilities found in Access and add a couple of useful features. I'll create an app that lists my customers and then lets me drill into customers and see their orders. Of course, there'll be forms to add new orders or customers, and we'll even add a workflow element that will send an email every time a new order is added. And we'll also add a secure login to make sure only certain users can access the data. Sound good? Okay, let's get started. I'll be using the MPower development platform since it makes the process so easy. The first thing I want to do is build an application over my list of orders from my Access database. In MPower, I'll start the build process by naming my application and choosing a template. The template is basically a customizable pre-built web application. It includes the layout and features, but also lets me customize it however I wish. I just need to tell MPower where my data is and how to sort it, which we'll do now. My data is in that Excel file that I exported from Access, so I'll just import that here. Then MPower uploads this data into a MySQL database table. Now, MPower works with any relational database, so I could just as easily use MSSQL, Postgres, iSeries, you name it. But I'm working with MySQL in this video. Once I've uploaded that data into a database table, now I just need to tell MPower which fields I want to include in my application. Okay, so now I can move on to the last step where I need to tell MPower how to sort this application. I'll sort it by order number and then move on. Now, I can add calculated fields, external logic, or filters to this application, but I don't need any of that this time. So I'll just move on to the build step. I'll click build and wait while MPower puts everything together for me. You'll notice that we've gone from an Access database to a web application built over that data in just a few minutes, all without any coding whatsoever. So now that that's built, let's check it out. As you can see, it's the same order data that you saw before. The big difference here is that I can view these orders from anywhere, whereas before I was confined to Access. It's the same data, it's just more accessible now. I can view all of my customer orders here, and even add new orders up here. Now, I don't love this form here, so let's go fix it up a bit real fast. I'll open up MPainter, which is MPower's visual editor. Here I can update the look and feel, add charts, maps, and really so much more. Right now, though, I just want to touch up the form. Once I move over to the form editor, I can rearrange this form how I want it. I'll organize the field so the form is more compact and easier to manage. And I've turned on layout mode so I can split rows, add or remove fields or rows, and rearrange fields however I want, just using simple drag and drop. Once it's done, I'll save everything. Now let's check it out. It's more compact and looks a lot cleaner now. Let's add a new order just to demonstrate that this works. I'll add a new order here using dummy customer data and then click submit. Now you see that a new order appears in the list. So this application is working great. I now have a way to view my Access data on the web and also add new data as necessary. Now, let's do something else. Let's add that email portion that was in Access. So let's say that my salespeople are in charge of adding new orders, but I want to have an email sent to the order processing department when a new order is added. Empower has a workflow element that makes this process real easy. In this case, when a new order is added, I want to perform an action. I can set it up to do all sorts of actions, but this time, let's send an email. I then need to set up the email that I want to send. I have to input a recipient, give it a subject, and create an email body. The nice thing is I can add database fields within this email body, so I can send all the details of the new order along with this email. Once that's all set up, let's go back to the form and check it out. I'll go in here and add another order real fast. Once I hit submit, it should automatically send an email to the email address that I specified in the workflow designer. Let's check that out. I'll open up that email account and check to make sure it's there. Great, as you can see, the email is here. Once I open it up, I can see the order details from the order I just submitted. So this is working great so far. All right, now I have my order data on the web, complete with an automated email notification when a new order is submitted. Now let's add my customer data and link it all together. I'll go back through the same build process that I showed you before, but this time I'll upload customer data that I exported from Access. I'm rushing through this build process because it's the same thing as I just showed you with the last application, just over different data. Now that I have it ready, let's build this. You'll notice that this was the same process as before, and that again is thanks to the templates, which really standardized the build process. Okay, the application is ready, but I want to make a quick change in MPainter before running it. I'd like to add a smart link to the customer name here and link it to the orders application I just created. A smart link connects two applications together and passes key data automatically. In this case, I'm passing the customer number, so when I click on a customer, it will let me drill down into only their orders. Okay, we're all set now, so I can save and run this. I now have a list of my customers, just like we had in Access, and as you can see, it's the same data. The nice part is, now I can click each customer's name to drill down into their orders. The application is smart enough to know which orders to display. So there we have it. In just a few minutes, I migrated data out of Access and turned it into a couple of connected web applications. Let's do one more thing before I wrap this up. Now that this data is on the web, it's currently available to anyone with this link. But what happens if you only want specific people accessing this data? I can turn on application security within Empower, which will force users to log in order to use the applications. Of course, once security is enabled, I need to add an authorized user. I'll do that really fast here and save the user. Now, when I try to use that application, I'm forced to log in. Of course, I can add all types of security features to my applications like secure sign-on, user privilege parameters, and multi-tenant security, which basically lets different users access the same app but see different data. But I don't need to do any of that in these applications. I just wanted to show you how easily you can add basic security in Empower. So we're all done now. In under 10 minutes, we've taken data out of Access, turned it into two connected web apps, created a workflow notification piece, and even added security. All this without coding. If you'd like to learn more about Empower or set up a demo, visit us on the web at mrc-productivity.com. Thanks for watching.